I look at this period and I think that it reflects the best of American democracy in ways that we've also seen across our history. Because every day we are provided the opportunity to determine who we will be as a country and as a society and as a people. And while elections are absolutely necessary, we were just talking about John Lewis, absolutely necessary, but they are not sufficient. We have to think about the hundreds and hundreds of days that happen in between elections and the ways that we act on those days to shape our country. And so when I think about history, I think about these moments, the non-election moments that we reflect on and that we remember that because they were so transformative. And when I think about the reaction to George Floyd's murder and the fact that we witnessed that globally, I know that that will be one of those moments that's transformative for this country, because there have been years and years of organizing. There have been years and years and years of agenda setting and the desire and the will to build capacity inside organizations and to do movement building. But at the same time, those moments created this well-plowed, fertile land upon which fell a national and a global reaction of horror and anger when people watched that 8-minute and 46-second video. And it became almost impossible, and I say almost because some still do, but almost impossible to refute the fact that there is a hierarchy of human value in our country that we've seen generation over generation, 100 years over 100 years. And people, I think, as was said during the civil rights movement, were sick and tired of being sick and tired. And so those things came together, the planning, the organizing, and this moment where so many people across races and ethnicity said, enough, enough, we're not doing this anymore. And so I've seen the fruit of that organizing and that capacity building, and we see it with the young people that we all have worked with. I've seen it through the electoral process where city councils were changed, state general assemblies were changed, their efforts to do so going forward in the next election, as well as the benefit of philanthropic work, work by some in the private sector to come together and to address that enough, we can't do this anymore. And my hope is that that will be sustained over a long period of time, that we won't grow weary of it, that we won't, quite frankly, grow bored with it, avert our attention to something else, become sick and tired of the discomfort that it must bring, and that we will stick with it so that we can bring about the kind of change that's necessary.